Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's look at the line by line explanation of the poem A Thing of Beauty by John Keats from class 12 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, consider subscribing. You can listen to the explanations of lessons from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. A Thing of Beauty is written by John Keats. Now this poem is an extract from his epic poem called as Endymion, a Poetic Romance. Now in this poem, the story is based on a Greek mythology where a shepherd named Endymion is going in search of his love. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. So the poet says that a thing of beauty is a joy forever. A thing of beauty means anything that is beautiful. So anything that is beautiful is a joy forever. What is forever means always. So he says that anything that is beautiful will give us happiness forever. Its loveliness increases. What is loveliness? It's beauty. So the loveliness of that beautiful thing keeps on increasing. It will never pass into nothingness. Nothingness means it will not decrease or reduce or disappear. So the loveliness of the beautiful thing or the beauty of the beautiful thing keeps on increasing and it will never decrease. But will keep a bower quiet for us. What is a bower? Bower is a shady place. So he says that beauty is like a beautiful shady place and which will give us a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. So he says that beauty is like a quiet and shady beautiful place under which we sit and relax. It will give us good sleep, peace and also good health and also quiet breathing. Therefore, on every morrow, are we writhing a flowery band to bind us to the earth, spite of despondence of the inhuman dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over-darkened ways, made for our searching eyes. Yes, in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. The poet tells us that there are so many beautiful things around us and all these beautiful things tie us to the earth. That means they bind us to the earth. So that is why he is asking, therefore on every morrow are we writhing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Every morrow means tomorrow or the next day. Writhing means binding or encircling. So he says that all these beautiful things encircle us and they tie us to the earth or bind us to the earth. So this is the reason why we all like to live, because we are connected to all the beautiful things around us. In spite of despondence of the inhuman dearth of noble natures, spite of despondence. What is despondence? Despondence is nothing but depression or hopelessness. So there may be hopelessness in front of our eyes or in our own lives, because the earthly life is full of negativities and there are so many sad moments, and these sad moments are caused due to various reasons. One of them is hopelessness and the other one is of the inhuman dearth of noble natures. Dearth means lack of something. So what is lacking here? Good people, with people with nobility. That means they don't have no good qualities in them. There are so many people around us, but most of them are very selfish and lack nobility. So that's why he says inhuman dearth of noble natures. That means people with good quality are missing. Of the gloomy days. Gloomy days means sad days. Of all the unhealthy and over-darkened ways. So there may be unhealthy days and there may be sad times also in our life. So our life is surrounded with all these things. That is lack of good people, dark days, sad days, unhealthy days, etc. made for our searching eyes, yes, in spite of all. So in spite of all these negative ways, that means lack of good people, sad days or unhealthy days or every time or any such moments when we keep searching for something good to happen. So in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. So he says that whenever you are sad or whenever you are surrounded by negativity, some shape of beauty moves away the pall. Pall here means some dark cloud or a cover. So it removes all the dark spirits from our eyes and it brightens us up. So when you see a beautiful thing, it gives you a lot of hope, it makes you happy and it makes you forget all the negativities and other negative things in your life. So in this second stanza, you can see that the poet has used some poetic devices like alliteration, in band, bind, noble nature, in some shape, etc. You can see the sound repeating. Then you can also see metaphor, writhing a flowery band. This flowery band is compared to all beautiful things that bind us to the earth. Then you can also see imagery, creating a sensory effect of beautiful things lined up in a string. So when you look at this flowery band, you can always have this image in your mind. So that's why it's called an imagery. So these are the devices used in this stanza. Such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep, and such a daffodils with the green world they live in, and clear rills that for themselves a cooling covert make against the hot season, the mid-forest break. So the poet says that there are so many beautiful things around us and these beautiful things are provided to us by nature. And what are some of the examples? According to him, he says that we find around us beautiful things like the sun, the moon, trees old and young. All the different kinds of trees and plants that we see around us, they are also beautiful compared to the sun and moon. These trees and plants are also very beautiful. And what do these trees and plants and do? They sprout a shady boon for simple sheep. That means these trees and plants provide shade not only for every other living thing, even all these small animals like the sheep or other things can enjoy the shade provided by these plants and trees. So it's not only the sun, moon and the plants and trees that are beautiful. He says that there are also daffodils with the green world they live in. Daffodils are small beautiful flowers and the green world is compared to the bushes where they bloom, especially in the forest. And you can also see clear rills. Rills are nothing but small streams. So all these things are also beautiful things given to us by nature. The sun, moon, trees, plants, daffodils and clear rills. So all these things are the beautiful things that we find around us. And what do these clear rills do? They make a cooling covert against the hot season. That means through whichever area they flow, they make that area very cool for themselves, especially during the hot season. And the mid-forest break is nothing but the process of slowing down. So they flow very slowly through these forest areas and they make a cool area through the region which they flow. So in this stanza also you can see that the poet has used certain poetic devices like alliteration, imagery, etc. So you can see the examples here. For alliteration, it is sprout, shady, simple sheep, cooling covert, etc. And imagery, when he is describing the trees giving shade or the daffodils in the green world they live in and the clear streams, etc. Rich with a sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms, and such too is the grandeur of the dooms we have imagined for the mighty dead. All lovely tales that we have heard or read, an endless fountain of immortal drink pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. Now the poet tells us that there are some more beautiful things around us like the musk roses which are having such sweet smell. They smell their fragrance and this also gives us happiness. Then he says that, and such too is the grandeur of the dooms we have imagined for the mighty dead. What is grandeur? Something very magnificent or high ranking or socially important. So we Doom means death. So we attach so much of grandeur to the death of mighty people. Now, who are these mighty people? Mighty people are great people who had lived inspiring lives. We look at their life stories and get inspired. There are so many leaders in our own countries and other countries who have encouraged us. For example, Alexander the Great from the world. And from our own country, we have Gandhiji, Nehruji, Shivaji, etc. So many great people are there around us. So when we look at them, their whole story itself, their life story itself is very important. And when these people die, we attach so much of importance even to their death, because their life story itself was inspiring. And the poet says that all these stories are also so beautiful, just like the other natural things that are found around us. So all lovely tales that we have heard or read, that means all these lovely tales are pertaining to the lives of these great people. So we might have heard these stories from other people, or we have also read so many stories about such people. So all these are endless fountain of immortal drink. So the poet says that all these beautifuls, from the sun, moon, plants, trees, animals, flowers, stories, everything is a fountain of immortal drink. That means it comes down to us in the form of a fountain. Now, what is an immortal drink? Immortal means something that never has death. So when you have this drink, you will never die. So he says that all these beautiful things come down to us like an immortal drink. So from where is this drink coming? Pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. So he says that this drink comes down from the heaven's brink. Brink means edge. So from the heaven we are getting this immortal drink, and this gives us a reason to live. So all the beautiful things that are around us gives us a reason to live, and it keeps us bound to the earth all the time. So the poetic devices used in this stanza are alliteration, as in her sound in have heard. Then you can see the metaphor is immortal drink. So immortal drink is nothing but all the beautiful objects of nature coming to us endlessly from the heaven. Imagery, so you can imagine the pictures of bushes full of musk roses, books describing the story of the fighters, etc. So all these are imagery. I hope you like today's video. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to My CBSE English Teacher. Please like, share, and give your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching.